Dear students, let's discuss the force dependency on a medium. Let's consider a situation when we have two charges Q1 and Q2 and say both of these are of same polarity, they'll repel each other, say with a force F1. In this situation, if I place a neutral body in the surrounding, like if I place a non-metal ball over here, we know well that due to these positive charges, some negative charges are induced over here, or we can say the dipoles of this ball will get polarized and the positive charges will be repelled away and negative will be developed close to it. Due to which obviously these negative charges will attract these charges toward the ball like this, or I can say a force FB, this is a force due to the ball, will be additionally exerted on both of these charges. It may or may not be equal, say we can write FB1 and FB2. Now in this situation, when the size of this ball will either increase or decrease, certainly the magnitude of FB1 and FB2 will change, but the force F1 which Q1 is exerting on Q2 or Q2 is exerting on Q1 will remain unchanged. Now see, if the size of this ball is increased, certainly net force acting on individually Q1 and Q2 will change because of variation in FB. Now, when the size of ball will increase to such a large extent that both of these charges are submerged into the medium of this material of which the ball was made up of. So we can say in this situation, both of these forces will certainly change. And in this situation, the net force acting on Q1 and Q2 will also change. Now in this situation, we can state when the two charges are submerged in a medium, the force which one charge is exerting on Q2 will not change, but the net force acting on individual charge will change. So we can write down a note over here which is quite important to understand. When charges are submerged in a medium, the force exerted by one charge on another does not change, but due to polarization of medium dipoles, net force on both charges decrease. Why it decrease? Because when the ball will be symmetric with respect to these two charges, the two forces FB1 and FB2 will approach to the same value. That is by symmetry, as well as these are acting in opposite direction. So net force acting on both of these charges will be less than F1, which will be decreased. And we can also mathematically analyze the value and we'll see how magnitude of force changes due to submerging the two charges in different media. As we already discussed, by Coulomb's law, we know that the force between the two charges is given as KQ1Q2 by R square, where K is the electrostatic constant which depends on a medium. And here electrostatic constant, we describe in detail this electrostatic constant. K is given as, the value of K is written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon, where epsilon is called permittivity of medium. This is again a constant parameter which depends on dipole characteristics of the medium, or it decides how much a medium can get polarized when charges are submerged into it. This permittivity is also further written as epsilon is equals to epsilon naught multiplied by epsilon r, where epsilon naught is written as a permittivity of free space. This is a universal constant. The value of this epsilon naught is written as 8.85 × 10⁻¹². Units you can deduce from the expression, it is Coulomb square per Newton meter square. In SI units we take. And in CGS units, it is also important to consider. It is written as 1/4 pi. It is in CGS units. It is rarely used, but you must keep it in mind, because when you substitute the value of epsilon naught as 4 pi here, for free space, the value of epsilon r is taken as 1. Here you can see the value of epsilon r we write as epsilon over epsilon naught, where epsilon is the permittivity of medium, epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. So this epsilon r is written as relative permittivity of medium. And obviously for a space, free space, the value of epsilon r is taken as 1. For all other media, as dipole exists, these get polarized and the value of epsilon r is always more than 1. Or we can say the permittivity of medium is always more than 1. We'll also discuss the relation of permittivity with the dipole strength of the medium in later part of this chapter. But you just keep in mind that now for free space, the value of electrostatic constant K can be written as 1/4 pi epsilon naught. When you substitute the value of epsilon naught, the result will be 9 × 10⁹. It is in SI units. And if we substitute 1/4 pi in CGS units, the value of K is 1. It is in CGS units. Just be careful when you use the value of K in different system of units while calculating force on different charge particles. So if we further analyze the situation, we can write, in free space, if we calculate the force between two charges, Q1 and Q2, say both are positive, they'll repel each other with the force F. And the value of F, we can simply write it as 1/4 pi epsilon naught, Q1 Q2 by R square. This is the value of electrostatic constant. And if we submerge the two charges in a medium, here you can write, when we submerged it into a medium, the situation would be like this. The force between the two charges will be, say, F dash. As we already discussed, this force will be less than that in the free space. Now, in this situation for the medium, if its relative permittivity is epsilon r, in which the charges are submerged, this epsilon r relative permittivity is also termed as dielectric constant. Now, if we are given with a dielectric constant, which is always more than 1, we can write that the value of force F dash is 1/4 pi epsilon naught epsilon r multiplied by Q1 Q2 by R square. As epsilon r is more than 1, always the force will be less than the initial force. And this force we can simply write as force which was acting between the two charges in a space divided by epsilon r. Now, in this situation, we know the force is reduced because this medium also exerted, a force onto the two charges in opposite direction. Say this force is Fm, due to which this force F dash is less. And if we talk about the force which Q1 is exerting on Q2 and Q2 is exerting on Q1, that will remain same. This will be F and F. So here we can say in medium, we can write for each charge. Here you can say F dash is equals to F minus Fm. Because we already discussed that the force which one charge is exerting on another will remain constant. It won't change. Medium exerted another force onto it, because of which the net force which is F dash is reduced. So if we substitute the value of F dash, which is F by epsilon R. So we can get the value of force exerted by medium. Force exerted by medium now can be written as F multiplied by 1 minus 1 by epsilon R. This is the force which medium has exerted on the individual charge. This is also a useful expression that will be used in various numerical problems. So just keep it also in your mind.